Hallelujah. Hosanna, Hosanna, you are worthy. You are worthy, you are worthy.
Hallelujah. Come on, somebody praise the Lord in this place. Come on, magnify the Lord in this place. Come on, Shabbat the Lord in this place with me. Hallelujah. Don't you know, God, we're ready to step in this morning. We're ready to step into the river. Come on, anybody want to step into the river of God this morning where things are flowing, where your body can be healed, your mind can be regulated. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, put your hands together this morning. Hey. We come alive in the river. 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 Come on, everybody, sing that. Come on. We come alive in the river. Hey. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. There is a current stirring deep inside. It's overflowing from the heart of God. The flood of heaven crashes over us. The tide is rising, rising right now. Bursting, bursting up from the ground. We feel it now. We feel, come on, tell them, we come alive in the river. Hey. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. Come on, sing it again, come on. We come alive in the river. Come on, you're stepping into the river of God.
We come alive in the river.
Hey,
we come alive in the river.
Stirring deep inside, it's overflowing into the heart of God. The flood of heaven crashes over us. The tide is rising, rising. Oh, well, it's bursting, come on, bursting, bursting up from the ground. We feel it now, bursting, bursting up from the ground. We feel, come on, tell them. We come alive in the river, hey. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river.
Come on, tell them you're coming alive, come on.
We come alive in the river,
yeah.
We come alive.
I can't hear you.
We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river.
I love this part. Break open prison doors. Set all the captives free. Yeah. Spring up a well. Spring up a well. Spring up a well in me. Yeah. Come on, say. Break open prison doors. Set all the captives free. Yeah. Spring up a well. Spring up a well. Spring up a well in me. Yeah. Nothing can stop this joy. We're dancing in the streets. Yeah. Spring up a well. Spring up a well. Spring up a well in me. Yeah.
Come on, tell them. Nothing can stop this joy. We're dancing in the streets, yeah.
Come on.
Spring up a well. Spring up a well. Spring up a well in me, yeah.
I love this part. Not just ankle deep, waist deep, all the way in. Not just ankle deep, waist deep, all the way in. Not just ankle deep, waist deep, all the way in.
Not just ankle deep, waist deep, all the way in. Not just ankle deep, waist deep, all the way in. Not just ankle deep, waist deep, all the way in. They're going 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 all the way in. Hey! We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river.
Come on, tell them.
We come alive in the river.
I'm coming alive, Lord.
We come alive in the river.
Come on, stick your feet in the river.
We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river.
Come on. Not just ankle deep, waist deep, but all the way in. Not just ankle deep, waist deep, but all the way in. Not just ankle deep, waist deep, all the way in. We're going all the way in. We're going all the way in. Come on. We're going all the way in. 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 Hey. I just believe that the Lord is releasing something that's not only troubling the waters, but also there's healing in the water. There's deliverance in the water. There's joy in the water. Come on. There's peace in the water. Glory to God. Whatever you need, if we're ready to step in to the water. Come on,
you gotta step into the water.
Hey, come on,
you gotta step into the water. You gotta step into the water.
What you gonna do?
We gotta step into the water.
Where your joy is, come on,
gotta step into the water.
Where your peace of mind is,
just step into the water.
Hey,
you gotta step into the water. You gotta step into the water. You gotta step into the water.
Come on, somebody know what I'm talking about.
You gotta step into the water. You gotta step into the water. You gotta step into the water.
Hey.
You gotta step into the water.
Not just ankle deep, waist deep, all the way in. Not just ankle deep, waist deep, but all the way in. Not just ankle deep, waist deep, all the way in.
You're going 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 all the way in. Oh God, we want to go all the way in. We want you to baptize us, Lord. In the river,
hey, come alive in the river. We 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 come alive in the river.
God, we learn how to call on your name. We know how to call on your name. Anybody know how to call on the name of Jesus? It doesn't matter. Sometimes we just call on him when we need someone to talk to. Sometimes we just call on him
when things are going great, and we just want to call, Lord, on the holy line and say, Lord, I'm doing great, God, and I thank you, God, because it's because of you. Well, sometimes we got to call him when we're in the midst of trouble and we're going through and something's not quite right in our lives, and we got to pick up the phone and call Jesus. You're calling his name. Oh, God, thank you that every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord. He is Lord. He is King. He is Savior. He is Master. He is Deliverer. Cause he is my protector. I call the name of Jesus. Cause he is my deliverer. I call the name of Jesus. Cause he is my provider. I call the name of Jesus. Cause he is my strong tower.
Oh,
in our Savior. Hey,
there's no name that is greater, that is stronger than our Savior.
Come on, tell them
there's no name that is greater, that is stronger than our Savior.
No name,
there's no name that is greater, that is stronger than our Savior.
Come on, one time,
there's no name that is greater.
We worship.
Come on, tell him that he's worthy. Come on, tell him.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Come on.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Oh, worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Come on, power. He's powerful. He's powerful. And he's glorious. And he's glorious. And he's glorious. Hey, his name is Jesus. It's Jesus. The lily in the valley. The Jesus. The rising morning star. Jesus. He is our promise keeper, Jesus, the healer, the healer. Come on, I feel him healing you right now, from the very crown of your head to the sole of your feet. He's a healer, he's a healer. Oh, way maker, way maker. Come on, he's making a way for you right now. Come on, come on. Yes, he is way maker. He's a way maker. He's got what you need. He's got what you need. Yeah. Jesus. 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 We love the calling. Jesus. Jesus.
You've always had our back. Yes, you did, God. Yes, you did.
Don't you know that you're a winner? Don't you know that God always has your back? That no matter what it looks like, when you begin to speak that, speak those things that you want. Speak that. Speak those things. Begin to open your mouth and declare. Speak those things. That we understand that the miracles are just one spoken word away. Jesus. Oh, we bless your name, God.
Such an easy thing for you to do, 'cause your hand is moving right now. You are still showing up at the tombs of every Lazarus, and your voice is calling me out. And right now, I know you're able, and my God, come. 'Cause you can do all things.
Yes, Lord.
You can do all things. But fail. 'Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. And I know you never will. You can do all things.
Come on, let him know what he can do.
You can do all things but fail, 'cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. And I know you never will. Come on, say you can. You can do all things. Oh, you can do all things but fail. 'Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. Cause everything's possible by the power of the Holy Ghost. A new wind is blowing right now, breaking my heart of stone, taking over like it's Jericho. And my walls are all crashing down. And right now, I know you're able. You can do all.
Come on, declare that in this room. Let him know.
You can do all things but fail. 'Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. It's I know, you never. The battle.
Come on, tell me.
You never lost a battle.
Oh,
you never lost a battle. And you never will. Come on, let them know. You never lost a battle. I always win. You never lost a battle. And you never will. You never lost a battle. You never lost a battle. I know that you got my back. You never will. Oh, you never will. Hey, you never will. Oh, you never will. Yeah, 'cause you can do all things. You can do all things but fail. 'Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. It's I know, you never will. Come on, come on, you can, yeah. You can do all things. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You can do all things but fail. 'Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. It's I know. You never will. I know, I know, I know. You never. Come on, I know, I know, I know. You never will. 'Cause you can do all things. You can do all things but fail. 'Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. And I know, you'll never win. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! You never lost a battle, God! Hey, come on, I need y'all to praise the Lord on that right there. Come on, he's never lost. You always win, even when it doesn't look like you're winning. Come on, I need you to praise God like you know that you're always on the winning side. And no matter what it looks like, no matter what's presented in ahead of you, the promises of God, the
promises of God. Oh, come on, on both sides. I'm going to go sit down, but I just want you to know. Intercede as you ask the Lord, 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 Lord. I know that you can do it, do it, do it. Y'all don't understand. I'm going to go sit down, though, because I know we got to keep moving. But I just need y'all to know. I need you to know, Tia, when it looks like you want to give up, that God said, no, I got something special for you, my daughter. You can't stop. You can't stop. Do y'all hear me in this place today? You can't stop. Come on, I just need you to declare it over your life while Pastor Simone is coming. I just need you to declare, I won't stop. I won't give up. I won't give in. I won't stop. I'll keep pressing. I'll keep pushing. I'll keep pressing. I'll keep pushing. I'll keep pressing. I'll keep pushing. Come on, come on. This is for somebody. I need you to push. I need you to press. I need you to push. I need you to press. Press towards the mark. It didn't say be still. You can't get to the mark unless you press. If you're pressing up against something, that means there's a resistance there. Oh, glory to God. But how many know that if you just press, you're gonna make it? Yeah. I believe that one, Norris, in my soul right there. You're gonna make it. You're gonna make it. You're gonna make it. I know when the Lord is using my voice to tear some things down. He's tearing some things down in the atmosphere. That doubt, that fear, that unbelief, that thing that says, oh, you can't do it. You can't make it. But God says, you're gonna make it. Cause with God, all things are possible. If you believe. All right, I'm done. But on that, I need y'all to praise the Lord. Come on that, I need you to give God some glory. On that, while Pastor Simone is coming, I need you to begin to shabak the Lord. It says in His word, shout to the Lord with a voice of triumph.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know somebody needed that word today. Hallelujah. I know somebody needed that word today. Hallelujah. You see, God did not bring you here because he did not want you to hear this. God wanted you to hear this word on today, and that's why he pulled you out from wherever you were to be in here in his presence on today. Thank you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, we thank you for your move, God. Hallelujah. We thank you for your move, God. Hallelujah. We worship you, God. Hallelujah. We worship you, God. Hallelujah. We magnify you, O God. Hallelujah. We magnify you, mighty God. Hallelujah. For you are worthy, O God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Woo, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. We thank you. Oh, how sweet is the presence of the Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Oh, how sweet it is to be in his presence. Glory be to God. We welcome you, Holy Spirit, and we thank you for being in our midst on today. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Such a sweet presence in this room. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. There's no place we'd rather be, oh God. No place. There's no place we would rather be, God. Thank you, Lord, for your presence. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. I don't know who needed to hear that word today, but God brought us here because someone needed to hear that word to press. You see, God, he said he will never leave us and he will never forsake us. But somebody needed to be reminded to keep moving. Somebody needed to be reminded of that today, to keep pressing, to keep moving, because God, he's with you. You see, Pastor T came forth in worship today, and all that God did here was done specifically for you. You see, God knew you were going to be here today. And all that he released on here today, he had you in mind. You were on his mind. You were on his mind. When he put the worship on her heart, on her tongue, you were on his mind. And I glorify God. Thank you, Jesus. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Good afternoon again, everyone. My name is Simone Graham, and we're really glad that you decided to join us here today. We know that there's so many places that you could have chosen to be today, but you chose here. And as we join together to fellowship, I just want to welcome each and every one of you. Holy Spirit, welcome each and every one of you in this room on today. If there are any first-time visitors, is there any first-time visitors with us on today? Any first-time, God bless you. Just raise your hand. God bless you, Prophet Matthew. God bless you. To God be the glory. Thank you for joining us on today. Bless the Lord. Thank you for joining us, woman of God. Your time is precious, and you've decided to come here on today to fellowship with us. So on the behalf of our leaders and the visionaries of this house, Apostle John and Pastor Talene Harris, we welcome you. For those who are online, the satellite members, we welcome you this morning. And for any newcomers, any new visitors online, if you're online and you're visiting us for the very first time, we ask you to just jump into the comment box and type new or first time. And so that after the fellowship is over, one of our leaders would definitely love to call you and connect with you, to pray with you, and to see how we can better serve you. So go into the comment box and type new or first time. And again, welcome to each and every one of you. We bless the Lord for you being here on today. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah. 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 I am here in this presence. God's presence is so strong in this place. And in this moment, thank you, Jesus. I am here. Jesus, yande na 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 mansori, ikandale kusatai. This is a perfect space. If you could just, before we do tithes and offering, just love on the Father in this presence because it's so strong. Hallelujah. Can we just love on Him as we prepare to take our tithes and offering? Hallelujah. Lord, we bless you. We bless you. We bless you. Hallelujah, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah, we bless you, Lord. Hallelujah, we bless you, God. Hallelujah, we thank you now. Hallelujah, and even I'm going to be obedient. Amen. Hallelujah. Saying, even as you prepare to bring your offering, that some of you in here, he wants you to bring yourself. Hallelujah. As you're bringing your tithes and offering, God says, bring you to me. He said, yes, I receive your offering, the monetary gift that you give, but the Lord says, I want you more. He says, I want you more. Hallelujah. So even as you prepare to come, prepare as you come up here. And even if you're not giving, if you're giving by electronically, still come, because the Lord says, I want you. The Lord is saying, I want you. Some of you in here, you've been rejected. I don't know who this is for. You've been rejected so much, even on this week. But the Lord says, come, as you come, give yourself to me. And you know who I'm talking to, because the Lord has disrupted this moment of offering to say, come. So as you come and give your tithes and offering, bring yourself to the Father. He's never going to leave you. He's never going to desert you. He loves you. Hear me. He loves you. Hear me. He loves you. Hallelujah. Amen. So I'm just going to say a prayer. I'm not even going to do the declarations. Father, as we prepare to come, if I don't know if the ways to give can be put on the screen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And even if you say, I am with the Father, he says there's another level. Hallelujah. And so, Father, we bring ourselves, as we bring our offering, I present myself as a living I present myself as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is my reasonable service. Can I just say this? What is it good, profit, for me to give my tithes and offering and I haven't given myself as a living sacrifice? So as we come bringing our tithes and offering on this morning, we present ourselves as well as a living sacrifice. Amen. So some ways to give. Hold on, let me see. If you want to give through Cash App, you can do $donate SOG. That's Cash App. I'm going to wait for it to come up on the screen. But if you have a cash gift, you can raise your hand if you would like an envelope, and our ushers will assist you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. So on the screens, if you want to give electronically, I already gave you Cash App, but we also have text to give. You can text the number. You can text GIVE to the number 762-583-8442. And if you want to give via Zelle, you can at spiritofgloryworshipcenter@gmail.com. Amen. As can I have someone to come with the offering to stand? Amen. And you can prepare to come at this time by the guidance of the ushers. Hallelujah, Jesus. Pray. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you now, oh God, for the gifts, oh God, that have been given unto you, Father. We pray, oh God, that you would multiply it, oh God, that it can be for the building of your house, oh God. Father, we ask that you bless those who have given, oh God, and those who desire to give. We declare increase over the people. And Father, even as they came out of faith, I thank you for the encounters that your people will experience, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And we seal this in Jesus' name. Amen.
We want to keep you in the know here at Spirit of Glory Worship Center, so here are our announcements. Happy birthday to all of our March birthdays here at Spirit of Glory Worship Center. March the 7th, T.S. Smith. March the 7th, Marquette Stevenson. March the 10th, Reverend Gloria McCall. March the 16th, Pastor Talene Harris. March the 16th, Jaden Prince. March the 19th, Naomi Prince. March the 22nd, Candace Carney. March the 26th, Donna Thomas. Enjoy your special day. Love the Spirit of Glory Worship Center family, Apostle John and Pastor Talene Harris. God is doing amazing things as he's continuing to call us to come together as prayer warriors for the Global Prayer Hub, the Center for Revival. John F. Harris Ministries and Spirit of Glory Worship Center presents this on Monday through Friday at 6 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Zoom ID, if you'd like to log in, is 843-9823-2658. And the passcode is 443-712. If you would like to also join us via telephone, you can with 301-715-8592. Let's continue to pray as God takes us higher. Are you called to dance? Are you interested in becoming a part of the dance ministry? Well, we're looking for those who would love to be a part of our dance ministry here at Spirit of Glory Worship Center. Please see Quarterio Neal for more information. This is open to all who have completed new members orientation. Spirit of Glory Worship Center is looking for an events manager position. This is an hourly position that will fluctuate depending on time schedules for events booked and churches that are leasing weekly time slots from Spirit of Glory Worship Center. The rate of pay is $20 per hour and will usually require weekend work. You must have a pleasant, friendly, and professional personality as you will be representing not only yourself but also God's kingdom, Apostle John, and Spirit of Glory Worship Center. Furthermore, you will need to be able to maintain the frequent changing schedule of events and stay abreast of any new event dates and times that are consistently being added to the calendar. If you are interested, please see Apostle John F. Harris for more information.
The Kingdom Education Department presents Online Youth Bible Study. Did you know that our online youth Bible study began January 31st? Don't worry, we have space available for your youth. Please join us this Wednesday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We welcome all youth between the ages of 4 and 17. We're super excited about what the Lord is doing because we have started our semester format of Bible study. We will meet every Wednesday for 8 weeks with a 4-week break intermission after each semester. We would love for you to join us via Zoom every Wednesday using meeting ID 852-578-53946, and our passcode is Bible. Meet our team. Under the direction of Apostle Linda Wilder, we have Prophet Naomi Prince, Prophet Candace Carney, and Minister Kenyetta Richardson. To sign up, please scan the QR code listed below, or if you have further questions or need details, please reach out to Apostle Linda Wilder after service. Thank you so much, and we look forward to seeing your youth there.
Hey there, my young adults. Join us via Zoom March 26th at 8 p.m. as we continue to get in tune with God. And we got a special topic for you this week, and it will be a 3-week series talking about forgiveness. And this week, we're talking about forgiving God. Now, that meeting ID is 899-3251-8423. And the password is YAM in all caps. Make sure you bring a friend as we talk about forgiving God and forgiveness over the next 3 weeks.
Royal Diamonds Women's Ministry, empowering queens. Resuscitation 2024. It's time to get restored, revived, refreshed, and renewed. Resuscitation Revive Restored Refresh Renew 2024. Save the dates, May the 17th through the 19th. Registration coming soon online. Let the fire of our altars never burn out. In-person intercessory prayer. Join us Friday, March the 22nd, 2024 at 8 p.m. right here at Spirit of Glory Worship Center. We look forward to seeing you here. Jill's Empowerment Training Center presents Beauty for Ashes event and fashion show, April the 20th, 2024, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. The theme is Fix Me, Lord. Special guest speaker, Dr. Atiyah Stevenson, hosted by Pastor Aubrey Reed. If you'd like more information for Beauty for Ashes event and fashion show on April the 20th, 2024, at 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., please see Pastor Aubrey Reed. We look forward to seeing you there. Beauty for Ashes events and fashion show needs your donations. Please donate clothes, gently used or new, shoes, jewelry, toiletries, perfumes, and lotions. The food items that are needed are paper plates, paper cups, utensils, desserts of different kinds, water, juice, coffee, paper napkins, food for lunch, and it will be about 100 people or more. Thank you so much for answering the clarion call for donations for this awesome event. Please see Pastor Aubrey Reed if you need more information. Join us for new members orientation. This is your opportunity to learn about your Spirit of Glory Worship Center, the vision, the mission, and the mandate. Join us Tuesday, March the 26th at 7 p.m. Zoom meeting ID is 829-5082-6630. And the password is new member, all lowercase. It's time to celebrate our first quarter SOG birthdays. Join us immediately following after service today. All are welcome. This has been your Spirit of Glory Worship Center, keeping you in the know. Your announcements for this week, govern yourselves accordingly and have a blessed and prosperous week.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God has really been speaking throughout this service, and I've been trying to just really contain all of the feelings and the emotions of what I feel in the spirit. But one of the things that he is definitely speaking in this season is he's requiring us to come up higher. He's requiring us to be holy. Nobody really wants to talk about holiness, but It is a requirement. God is looking for you to walk in holiness. And if you're not sure what that looks like, then get with one of the leaders. Ask myself or apostle, but he is requiring us. He's setting us apart from what's happening in the world. If you say that you love God and you're following him, you have to set yourself apart. Jesus.
Holiness, holiness is what I long for. Holiness is what I need. Holiness, holiness is what you want for me. For me. Righteousness, righteousness is what I long for. Righteousness is what I need. Righteousness, righteousness is what you want for me. For me. So take my heart and mold it. Take my mind, transform it. Take my will and conform it to yours, to yours. Oh Lord, brokenness, brokenness is what I long for, and brokenness is what I need. Brokenness, brokenness is what you want. From me, so take my heart and mold it, take my mind and transform it, God, take my will right now and conform.
So take my heart and mold it. Take my mind, Jesus, and transform it. Take my will and conform it to yours, to yours. Oh Lord, oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, you require holiness, righteousness.
If everybody could just stand to their feet just for a moment. Come on, if you're able. Come on, if you could just stand to your feet, because God's presence has been here through the whole time since we began. Hallelujah. Come on, just take about 10 seconds and just worship the King of Glory.
Just right here in this atmosphere, just lift those hearts up, and lift those voices up, and just give God your best worship. Come on, this is when you go vertical. When you worship, it's when you go vertical. It's not what you say about God, but it's what you say to Him. God, we love you. Come on, go vertical. God, I adore you. Come on, it's a vertical thing. It's straight up and down. It's between you and Him. Don't have nothing to do with nobody else. God, I thank you. God, I bless you for sparing my life. God, I thank you. Thank you for your presence in this place. We acknowledge your presence in this room. Spirit of the living God, we thank you. Thank you that you're here now. Your power is here. Your glory is here. Oh, your anointing is here. Your anointing is here. Your spirit is here, Lord. Your power is here, Lord. Your glory is here. Your splendor is here. Your reign is here. Your rule is here. Your dominion is here. Breakthrough is here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sickness and disease has to leave here. Oh, bless your name. Bless your name, God. Whatever you need is in this atmosphere. The Spirit of the Lord is in this room. The Spirit of the living God is in this room. He's in the room. He's in the room. I feel his anointing here. Moving up and down these aisles, I feel his hand here. The hand of God be upon you. The hand of deliverance be upon you now. Breakthrough be upon you right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. Sweet Holy Spirit, thank you that you're here now. Glory to God. Glory to God. There's no place like your presence. As I stand here as God's son and a man of God, I make a declaration now that the atmosphere that's cultivated in this place, which is glory, the presence of the Almighty God, speaking, I declare that you are about to have new encounters in God's face and in God's presence. You're about to see new demonstrations in the presence of the Lord. So I sat at my desk on Friday, I think it was Friday or Thursday, as I spoke with someone, and I'm not going to disclose their testimony, the fullness of it. If they were here, they wanted to, they could themselves. But the doctor gave one report about their child. And I said, whose report do you believe? Because the doctor said the wheelchair is going to be their portion until further notice. But the Lord spoke to me and said, I want you to see the hand of deliverance move, because he still works miracles. So when I talked to her Tuesday, the distress, despair, and listening to the distraught voice. And then when I talked to her on Friday, the rejoicing and the joy and the jubilation because of breakthrough and victory. And my son is not just in the hospital, but he's up walking and running and... Thank you, Jesus. Playing outside with his friends. God is a miracle worker. I said he's a miracle worker. And I don't have a lot of time today because we have a service, another church that actually rented our facility for a 3 o'clock meeting. So I don't have a lot of time today, but I got a little time to give God the glory. But I want you to know that the Bible says that these signs shall follow them that believe. How many believers do we have in this room? How many believers do we have in this room? I feel the Holy Spirit moving in this place. Thank you, Jesus. See, the time is now where we're not running to just the ministers, pastors, evangelists, apostles, prophets, and teachers. But the Lord's going to begin to speak to you, and God's going to bring demonstration through your hands. I speak and declare he's going to bring demonstration through your prayers. He's going to bring demonstration to your through your declarations. There's going to be people that you come into contact with that won't have time to call me. They won't have time to get to the church. They won't have time to get to a Zoom or a Clubhouse or some type of social media prayer gathering. But you be the pathway. You be the person that stands in the gap for them and make up the hedge. And the glory of the Lord is going to flow through your hands and move through your lips and move through your body and move through your mouth and move through your prayers. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just want someone just to shout. Give God a praise in this room as I get ready to share this word, release this word this afternoon. Just give God a shout of praise in this word. Come on, clap your hands, all you people. And just shout to God with a voice of victory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And hallelujah. Amen, amen, and amen. Amen. You can be relax in the presence of the Lord. You can be seated, relax in God's presence. Good to see everybody that's here. Those of you that are visiting for the first time, we bless God for you. A few of you actually were here at 11:30 in the morning. But I want to acknowledge Tiffany, that'll lose your car, Tiffany. I want to acknowledge Tiffany Holden. Did I say that correctly? Amen. Tiffany Holden was here at about 11:30 this morning. She is new to the neighborhood, so the Lord blew her in here at 11:30 this morning. God bless you. We welcome you. We appreciate you so very much. All right. Also want to welcome and appreciate the Lord for our sister Sheila Russell. Sheila Russell. I don't take calls on Sunday mornings before I get ready to minister, but I looked at the phone and the Holy Spirit said, take that call. So I use it, don't answer the phone, because I never know who's going to be on the other end. It's going to disrupt my spirit. But this particular time, I was led to take the call, and it was Sister Sheila Russell on the other end that said, what time does show service start? Said, I'm in the parking lot of one church, but this just ain't it. Hallelujah. Sheila Russell, wave your hand in the back if you will. God bless you. Come on, let's thank God for Sheila Russell that's here. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right. I think this is Glennis. Is that Glennis? Bless you, Glennis. Marrero? I was going to, yeah. I took a look at it. I'm like, I'm not going to say it at all. Today. You got to be kidding me. Are you serious? So you're a new neighbor that was blown in here today. You were at another church this morning, and you couldn't go in because... Wow. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I want someone just to comfort her. Just embrace her with some love this morning. Thank you, God. This afternoon, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God, we thank you that you are a my God. We thank you that you are a healer, you're a deliverer. God, we thank you. Wow. 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 God, we thank you for your peace, your comfort. Thank you for your joy. My God. My God. My God. Let me share something with y'all really quickly. I wasn't going to even talk about this, but see, 11 Action News and whoever else, Fox News, put us all on local television today. We all over the news. Not because of something we did, but because of something that happened across the street that had nothing to do with us. So they highlighted near the local church, the Spirit of Glory Worship Center. I came here and there was about eight police officers next door, crime tape all around that vicinity. The investigation bureaus investigating a crime scene because there was an attempt at murder across the street. Amen. It had nothing to do with Spirit of Glory, had nothing to do with anybody connected to us at all. But the spotlight was on Spirit of Glory Worship Center because it happened next to the local church, a Spirit of Glory Worship Center. I'm looking at the news report and I'm looking at our name in the news because of something that the enemy meant to bring death and devastation. And I said, Father, this is not good publicity. We don't need anybody seeing this at all. And the Lord said, just watch me work. And I'm sitting here this afternoon, and three people said that God blew them in here. They moved to the neighborhood, and they couldn't go into one ministry because they said God sent them here. There's 1, 2, 3 people, and God said, watch me work, because what the devil meant for evil, God will turn it around for your good. You are a spotlight. You are a light that shines in dark places. Testimony of the power of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So you may think one thing is happening that the enemy has announced and said and tried to establish as your future, but God is a God of a turnaround. He's turning it around in your favor. I don't have but a short time to get through this message this afternoon, and we're going to be dismissing in just a few moments. But Sister Sheila, if the Holy Spirit is not real, He's real. He's real, and when you listen to the message and the word, you're about to find out why. Because I didn't know anything about what you just shared. I don't know anything about what you have experienced 4 days ago. Nothing at all. As I was even attempting to deviate from what I was going to share because of time's sake, the Holy Spirit would not allow me to do so. I had to release this word this afternoon. The book of St. John chapter 11, quickly, St. John chapter number 11, and I'm going to be very expeditious and about, if y'all help me and don't look at me crazy, I can get finished faster. But if you look at me funny, it may take me a little longer. All right? All right. Thank you, Jesus. Lazarus was dead, but he still heard the word. Lazarus was dead, but he still had a word. There is a word out that death cannot stop. Tribulation can't hinder. Problems can't disrupt. Adversities can't dismantle. Circumstances can't dispel. Situations cannot eradicate, because there is a word that's been sent, and Lazarus was even dead, but he still carried a word. But how we view death is not how God views death. Sister Sheila promised, I did not know you had this situation going on. God views, he views what we may call the end of the story as an opportunity for the birthing place of something new that you did not even know was about to happen. But I want to just announce right now, without trying to be audible and loud at all, it is not my desire to elevate my decibels, but there is something new that's springing forth in your life. It may have looked like something had died. It may have seemed as though something had dissipated. It may have looked and appeared as though something had has had its cessation and come to an end, but there is something new that's springing forth in your life, and I give God the praise for it. You will not look like how they left you. Your comeback won't look like your setback. Your resurrection won't look like your beating. Your renewal won't look like your demise. Your restoration won't look like your attack. Oh, I thank you, God. And when God builds you up and gives you recompense, it won't look like your sabotage, because God says there's power in resurrection. Woo, God, I thank you. When you spring up out the ground, you don't look like the pain that you endured. And this is an opportunity for God to show himself strong on behalf of those who said, Father, I'm still going to trust you. Father, I'm still going to worship you. Father, I'm still going to bless you. Father, I'm still going to magnify your name. Because if you continue on, you're going to see the hand of God and what God has already prepared for those that love him. If you continue in faith, you're about to see the goodness of the Lord. And I just prophesy and declare right now in the name of Jesus, the five people that were just catch this, it's the time to spring up and to come out. You may have been dropped in the ground and left for dead, but the Lord says it's time to come up, it's time to come forth, and it's time to come out. Come out, come out wherever you are. They may have sabotaged you, dropped you, rejected you, denied you, but you're not going to come back the same way that they left you. Your renewal and your resurge and your springing up will not look like the pain and the shame. As a matter of fact, the Bible says that for your shame, you got to have double. For your pain, you got to experience the just reward. That's what the word says. Don't cast away your confidence, which has great recompense of reward. For you got to need a patience that after you've done the will of God, you got a prize that you're about to receive. I want to talk about the reward. Can someone just shout, reward me, Lord? Because a reward is not the same as an award. An award is one time only, but a reward is something that God says, because I position you in this place, you're going to have a reward. I'm going to do it over and over and over and over and over and over again. You are not going to be awarded. You're going to be rewarded. When you step into the place of being rewarded, it means that I've done something good before God. I stood when everything said fall. I kept pressing when everything said draw back. I kept standing when everything said just go ahead and quit and give up. And God said, because of this, you are about to experience a reward. It's going to go from glory to glory, even upon your children, your sons, and your daughters are going to experience the blessing because of your yes. Hallelujah. Everything connected to you is about to experience the manifestation of what God said. I don't care what it looked like. God said so. God said so. God said so. I'm going to read John 11 in just a few moments, but God will preserve your life in order to preserve your purpose. God has to preserve your life so he can preserve the purpose for your life. And that's why it's illegal for anything to kill you. You can't die if you're standing in God's will. That's why Jesus said, look at here. Ain't nobody got the power to take my life. I have the power to lay it down. I have the power to take it back again. When I'm ready, I'll give up the ghost. When I'm ready, I'll yield up my spirit. If I lay it down, I can take it back again. Why? Because you can't kill what God has already blessed. You may have thought it was something that died. It just transitioned to live in a new glory. Because when you carry God's will, you can't kill. You can't kill what's been anointed to fulfill purpose. You can't kill. That's why the devil said, look here. I've been trying to get to Job, but I can't get to him because there's a hedge around Job. But if you lift up the hedge and let me have him, he'll curse you himself. And God said, and I bet you, no, he won't. I'll lift up the hedge. You can attack the things that are around him. You can hit his body. You can hit his material. You can take his livestock, but you can't kill him because he's still going to glorify me. And when he comes out of this, I'm going to reward him because he's going to go from glory to glory. He is not coming back the same way he went down, but he's got to have a due reward. He's going to have just recompense, and restitution is coming in his life. I prophesy now from the wells of my belly, and I say now in the name of Jesus, you are about to experience restitution and recompense and complete renewal in Jesus' name. Jesus was beaten so badly. I'm going to get to John 11 in a minute. I think I am. Jesus was beaten so badly that he no longer looked like a human being. He was marred beyond recognition. He was beaten to the point. Please excuse me for sounding grotesque. And remember these little cute little pictures that we have picturing the sufferings of the Messiah. They don't do it justice. That's not real. That's fictional. Because if you can understand the cat of nine tails, and then at the end of each of the leather, there was glass or metal or bone. And every time it hit the flesh, it would rip flesh out of the body. So he was hit 39 times. Can you imagine that, ripping flesh out of your body 39 times? But he's still saying, look here, I'm still going to walk up my own hill. I'm still going to go to my own cross because nobody can take my life. You have hit me, but I'm not going to die until it's time to fulfill purpose. And when it is finished, I'll yield up my spirit. Jesus resurrected, and he walked on earth 40 days after resurrection, and he walked in the midst of the same people that were privy to or the perpetrators of his passion, his crucifixion. He walked in the midst of the same people and they didn't even recognize him, because you don't come back the way you went down. They didn't recognize him because the resurrection power of God will make sure that you don't look like your shame and your pain. May I talk to somebody and let you know right now that the power of God is moving, and you shall not look like your pain or your shame. And God even says, for your shame you must have double. Pastor Derek, it had only been 3 days. Whatever carnage was hanging off should have still been hanging off. Whatever marredness he had in his body, it was only 3 days. You should have still been able to see it. But see, some people are wanting to rejoice because of how they left you. I want somebody to get rid of this shot right here. Some people are looking to find you the way they left you. But because of the resurrection power of God, they're completely confused. They're completely confused because you don't look like the way they left you. And when God's power is upon you, they'll be walking all around you and can't access your life any longer because you don't look like how you were thrown down. But the way you came out and the way you came up is different from how you went down. And they're trying to see, do you have any resemblance of how I beat you? You still look like how I nailed you. You still look like how I speared you. But because you don't, they can't find you no more, because it's the power of God's resurrection. I got to get ready to go home, because somebody give God some praise for about 5 seconds right here. Hallelujah. Woo! I'm trying to find the effects of how I beat you. I'm trying to look for the effects of how I smote you. I'm trying to see if you still carry some resemblance of flesh hanging off your body and your back all wide open and your chest is wide open. If you have some resemblance, because I was the one that did that, and God will make sure as you walk around in front of your enemies, but you don't have the shame. You got a new table. I thank God for the new table, and he prepares for me in the presence of my, in the presence of my, in the presence of my enemies. Somebody shout, it's a new table. Now see, what's so awesome about God is he'll let people come look at the table, but they can't sit at the table, because the table has only been prepared in the presence of your enemies. But the table is not for your enemies. The table is simply for them to look at and say, you did not kill them. You only propelled them. You only elevated them, because their comeback won't look like their setback. Jesus had to walk around in the presence of his enemies for 40 days on the earth. Y'all thought he immediately went up to heaven? No, he immediately went to hell. I'm going to finish this out so folks don't be left confused. He went to hell. The part that's called paradise in the lower part of the earth. He went down and led captivity captive, and it took the keys from death, hell, and the grave. And it says, you ain't got no power no more. And that's like they couldn't take my life. You can't take their life until I'm ready for them. You can't have them until it's time. You can't destroy them unless I say it's time and they fulfill purpose. That's why I said it's power in the will of God. He takes the keys of death, hell, and the grave. He couldn't take the keys of hell until he went into hell. Thank you, Jesus. My God. Because whatever you can't walk out of, you don't have the power over it. There's some things that God allow you to go through so that you can walk out of it. Because when you come out of it, you can stand with boldness and authority and say, now I got the power over it, but I have to walk out of it. It's not what you, my God, it's not what you can go into, but it's what you can come out of. I don't care about what you went through. Did you come out of it? Did you come out on the other side? And Jesus had to come out. Because only then in Matthew 28, he can say, now all power is given unto me. Whew. Heaven and on earth, all power. And I have the keys to death, hell, and the grave. Oh, grave, where is your victory? Oh, death. Where is your sting? One of the things that the enemy tries to use to bring us into fear is the fear of death. But Jesus said, wait a minute, I took the sting out of death. Took the sting out of it. So you can't intimidate me with death. Because it has no sting. Who? I got to get to the lesson. I got to get to the word in just a minute. I'm going to get there. Tanika, I'm going to get to the word in a minute. See, one of the things that the enemy tries to use is the fear of something dying. if it's not the physical, biological ceasing to walk around and have oxygen that you breathe and a pulse in your body, or the rhythm of your heart, then there's something else that will die. He wants to give us, keep us captive to the fear of something dying. Death. Where is your sting? That's why deliverance is happening in this room right now. Where is your sting? It's no sting any longer. Because St. John 10:10 says, I can't, the enemy comes, the thief comes, but to steal what? And to kill and to destroy. But Jesus said, I came that you might have life. I'm coming to give you life. I'm coming to give you life. I'm coming to give you some life. I'm giving you life and that more abundantly. I want somebody to just shout life. He's come to give you life. I'm not mad about no sting of death. I'm not here to receive the enemy's portion. Amen. Of something being stolen, something killed and destroyed. But Jesus said, I've come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. So God will preserve your life in order to preserve the purpose for your life. I got to go. I got to read John 11. Holy Spirit, if you don't want me to, I won't. I'll stop here if this is good enough. So, thank you, Lord God. Y'all help John 11? John 11? John 11? Okay, let's go ahead and let's read this. Let's read this word. Read this word. John 11, chapter 1. Chapter 1, verse 1. Chapter 11, verse 1. I'm going to get it right. John, chapter 11, verse 1. And the word of the Lord says, now a certain man was sick. There was a certain man that was sick named Lazarus. Can somebody just say Lazarus? Say Lazarus. Uh-huh. Of Bethany. I want you to say Bethany. There's a reason why I'm having you to say this. It's not because I don't have anything to articulate in this text this afternoon. But there's a reason that I want you to say this, because Lazarus and Bethany have significance. Understand this, that there are no meaningless details in the Word of God. Because Lazarus has a name with a definition that's powerful, and Bethany has a name that's very interesting, that Jesus spent a lot of time in Bethany. As a matter of fact, before this particular text here in scenario, in John chapter 11, they just made another attempt to kill and execute Jesus in John chapter 10 in this exact same place, in a place called Bethany. They attempted to murder him. They wanted to execute him. But see, you got to understand how powerful this is. You can't take anything that God owns. You can't take the will of God. You can't kill anything until the appointed time for that person to offer up the spirit, because purpose has been fulfilled. This is not in my notes, but go ahead and take this anyway. See, the devil wants to kill, but God said death is beautiful because there is no sting in death. But the devil wants to kill your life. Why? Because when you kill something, that means you cut the life off short before it can fulfill purpose, before it could fulfill what God said. But when you die, it simply means I have finished my work and I'm transitioning to the other side. So there's no sting in death. Thank you, Lord. So Satan wants to kill. He wants to kill. So, okay, let's go ahead. Okay, let's go. So now a certain man was sick named Lazarus of Bethany, the town of Mary and her sister Martha. And it was the Mary which anointed the Lord with ointment and wiped his feet with her hair, whose brother Lazarus was sick. Mary anointed the feet of Jesus in Bethany as well. Amen. She broke open the alabaster box and she gave something that was very costly in a town called Bethany. Now, I have to give you a definition of Bethany, because here's this woman that has an alabaster box that's very costly and very opulent and was actually the equivalent of 1 year's of wages, but she took something that was very costly in a town called Bethany, and she broke it open in front of everybody. So here she is in a place called Bethany. And one definition means a house of figs. Another definition means a house of affliction. And another definition for Bethany means a house of poverty. So here is a Mary that has an alabaster box that's very costly, and she breaks open a year's wages, and she begins to anoint the feet of Jesus in the middle of a people that says, wait a minute, this is a house of poverty. Why are you wasting this? This is a house of affliction. Why are you doing this? Because the mindset was saying, your worship is too exorbitant. Your worship costs too much. But Mary says, I will break it open and smear it all over him, because I'm going to preserve him. And Jesus said, wait a minute now, leave her alone, because what she's done is actually going to testify in my name. Here is a testimony. Now Jesus, as they attempted to crucify him in Bethany, but it was not time for him to die, so he could not be killed. I'm gonna let that sink in. I'm going to let that sink in. It was not time for him to die, so he could not be killed. Somebody would get that in the morning after you have some Cheerios, some Frosted Flakes, some Rice Krispies, some oatmeal, hallelujah, and some Raisin Bran. It'll sink in. You'll get it in just a few moments. You couldn't kill him. It was not time for him to die, so you can't kill him. The word Lazarus means God has helped me. Lazarus finds himself in a grave before he fulfilled the purpose in his name. Y'all got it. Y'all got this right. He finds himself in a grave in a place called Bethany before he fulfills the purpose on his get. That's why Jesus said, wait a minute, you think he's dead, but I'm going to give you another word. He's only asleep, and I'm glad he is, because I'm going so I can help him. I don't have time to exhaust this text. I don't have time to exhaust this text. I don't have time to extrapolate like I really want to. See, Lazarus' name carries power. Lazarus' name means I'm helped by God. But Lazarus died in Bethany. Or was he asleep? He was put in a tomb, and he was there for 4 days. Was he really dead? Or was he only asleep? But Jesus said, wait a minute. He actually is dead. But Jesus said, I'm glad for your sake. But he can't literally die until I go and help him, because he's got to come out of there, and he's not going to come out the same way he went in. In the house of Bethany, which means a house of figs, which means a place of affliction, which means a place of poverty, here is this Mary that Jesus shows up to, and he said, my brother's name is Lazarus. But do you remember the alabaster box? God, I don't want to preach. Do you remember the alabaster box? Because I know I'm in an environment that says you're wasting your worship. It don't take all of that. You wasted about a year's wages, and even your disciples, they were rebuke me because I broke open the alabaster box. But Jesus, you let me anoint you, because I was doing something for another time in the future. I thought it was for you, but it was really for my brother. My God, you better get this. I thought it was for you, but I was actually sowing a seed in my worship for my brother named Lazarus. Because now here comes Jesus running back to Bethany, and the disciple says, wait a minute, are you trying to go back to the house of poverty? poverty? Are you trying to go back to the house of figs? Are you trying to go back to a place of affliction? And here is Thomas that rise up and said, well, we're going to go with you. We're going to just die with you then. And Jesus said, wait a minute. I got to go to Lazarus now, because Lazarus is actually asleep. No, he's not. He's dead. But he'd been dead about 4 days. But I got to go that I may awaken him. And then Jesus comes into Bethany, and Mary looks at her, at him, and said, and Jesus says, Mary, do you believe I can raise him from the dead? Do you believe he can be raised from the dead? And Mary says, I believe he can, but in the last day at the resurrection. Because you got to understand something about the mindset of poverty. It pushes back what God wants to do now until sometime in the future. But here comes God's glory, because Jesus said, wait a minute, I am. Somebody shout, I am. He says, I am the resurrection and the life. Though he were dead, yet shall he live. The mindset of religion has a twin brother called poverty. Because religion will have you pushing back what God wants to do now into some point in time in the distant future. And Jesus says, I am the resurrection. In other words, I've showed up. Where have you laid him? I haven't read the text, y'all. I'm just taking off and preaching. I haven't read the text. Where have you laid him? Where did you put him? And she still said, wait a minute, what do you mean, where do we put him? You should have come when we first called you. We called you when he was sick, and you waited until he was dead. And then it took you extra 2 days after he was dead to get here. And now you want to know where we have laid him. Don't you know that by now he is stinking? What is it that God is about to bring resurrection life to, that everything around you said, it's over, it's done, and by now it stinks? Watch this. What you believe in God for stinks by now. What you standing in faith for, stanking. What you believe in to see in the goodness of God, stanking. Leave it alone. What you believe in God to do in your life, it stinks. Say stinks. I said it stinks. What you believe in God to do, when you know he promised you, but it seemed like it took too long, and by now just leave it alone. And Mary said, well, just leave him alone, because I want to push what you want to do now back into sometime in the future, because by now it's got to be stinking. It's been too long. But Jesus pauses and waits until Lazarus was dead, and then he says, now I'm going to go. And he walks. Doesn't make no sense, does it? What could have been a healing service ends up being a resurrection service. But all the folks in Bethany that said, Mary, God, I thank you. Your worship was a waste. Woo, God, I thank you. All the people in Bethany that said, Mary, the alabaster box that you broke open, you could have given that to the poor. You wasted that much money by taking that and rubbing it on his feet. And all the people that saw Mary and her worship had to come to her house. Because in the 4 days, y'all still follow me now. Y'all still tracking, right? You're good. Because in the 4 days, they had the time to call the professional mourners. I mean, you know what professional mourners are, right? Those are people that are paid to come lament with the cheese and the wine and the harps and the sad songs and the made-up fake tears to put on some pomp and some hype and some circumstance at your family member's funeral. And they're paid to lament. They're paid to wail. They're paid to cry. And Jesus said, all of them are there, but they're not going to continue on in the whining and crying and the lamenting. They're about to witness in Bethany the resurrection of the thing that they said is stinking by now. And Jesus says, where have you laid him? They come to Mary's house. You wasted all this in this. We already call the house of poverty. You wasted the value of an alabaster box. And now here is Jesus showing up at your house. Wait a minute. Mary. Now I totally agree that the word says that Mary did it for the burial of Jesus. Watch this. But it wasn't time for Jesus to die yet. She did not know that her brother was going to be sick. My God. Where is your worship going? Because Jesus shows up at Mary's house and says, I'm here. And she says, if you only had come when we called you. If you only had come when we called you, my brother would still be alive. How many have experienced God in your life not showing up when you called him? I don't hear nobody. He didn't come the way you wanted him to come. You wanted him to show up like this, but it seemed like he waited a little longer. You wanted him to come the exact time that you called him, but he waited a little bit longer, and you couldn't understand the time frame and the time work of the Most High God. But I'm so thankful to God, and God said, listen, Lazarus, what's your name mean? Excuse my vernacular. Please pardon my grammar. I promise I can articulate very well. Lazarus, what's your name mean? My name means you help me. So it does not matter if you're dead and in the grave. You cannot die until you fulfill purpose. So Lazarus has to be resurrected in the middle of all of these people. That number one, they saw Mary's extravagant and exorbitant worship. Number two, they just tried to kill Jesus. God, I thank you. My time is almost up. If I don't say anything else, I have preached already. I've released this word. You have a testimony in your name. And I am not talking about the name that your natural mom and daddy gave you, and that may be what's written in heaven, or it may not be. But you have a new name that's written in heaven, the Bible says. And your new name carries the weight of your purpose. Holy Spirit, I don't have a lot of time. I can't believe it's 2 o'clock already. That's not right. It's not 2 o'clock, is it? It's not right. I said it's not right. No, it's not. It's not right. Because I got a couple of more things I got to share with y'all. St. John chapter 11, verse number 1 says, "Now a certain man was sick named Lazarus of Bethany." The details in the Bible are significant. Look to your neighbor and say, the details make the difference. There was a certain man named Lazarus. The Bible takes the time to say named Lazarus. There's something in his name that's weighty. And of Bethany, the town of Mary. It's not insignificant that it specifies and highlights the town of Mary. There's purpose in that as well. And her sister Martha. And it was the Mary which anointed the Lord with ointment and wiped his feet with her hair, whose brother Lazarus was sick. Therefore his sister sent unto him, saying, "Lord, behold, he whom you love is sick." When Jesus heard that, he said, "This sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God might be glorified thereby." But he's speaking about a place where they just tried to kill him. Now Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. And when he had heard, therefore, that he was sick, he abode 2 days still in the same place where he was. It doesn't make any sense, does it? He heard that he was sick and he just stayed put. Sometimes you want a healing service when God's about to give you a resurrection service. Then after he said to his disciples, "Let us go unto Judea again." His disciples said unto him, "Master, the Jews of late sought to stone thee. Goest thou thither again?" Jesus answered, "Are there not yet 12 hours in the day? And if any man walk in the day, he stumbleth not, because he seeth the light of this world. But if a man walketh in the night, he stumbleth, because there is no light in him." Then verse 11 says, "These things said he, and after that he said unto them, Our friend Lazarus sleepeth." Are y'all reading with me? I know I'm all over the place. I should have probably read first and then preached later, but I'm reading now, so we're going to be all right. "Our friend Lazarus sleepeth, but I go that I may awake him out of his sleep." Jesus uses terminology that's not the same that we do. He will use terms that we are familiar with, but his first go-to was not death. His first go-to was, "Lazarus is taking a nap." Sometimes you think things are gone, but it's really just taking a nap. That's right, baby. I got an amen. Come on, she's amen. Thank you, baby. The rocks will cry out. The children will cry out. The babies will cry out. Verse 12 says, "Then said his disciples, Lord, if he's asleep, he shall do well. Howbeit Jesus spake of his death. But they thought he had spoken of taking of rest in sleep. Then said Jesus unto them plainly." Here he is. Okay, I'm going to talk to you the way you can understand. Let me talk in plain language, because I'm trying to give you revelation and you're just not catching it. I'm trying to let you know that he's not dead. He's only asleep. So since you need me to talk to you straight, Lazarus dead. Y'all reading this right with me? Verse 15 says, here's something else that tripped me up a long time. Are y'all reading? Verse 15 says what? Start off, help me read it. What does it say? Wait a minute. Hold on. Verse 14 says, Lazarus is what? Dead. And then he goes on to say in verse 15, the first four words, and he says what? Lazarus is dead, and Jesus says what? Lazarus is dead, and Jesus says what? I am. He says, I'm glad. Why? Because there's something that he's about to do in his comeback that he could not do before his setback. Because before this happened to Lazarus, ain't nobody heard nothing about Lazarus. Excuse my vernacular, Pastor D, you educators, please pardon me. Ain't nobody heard nobody talk about Lazarus, nothing he did, nothing he said. You heard nothing about him. You heard about his sister. You heard about Martha. Anybody ever heard about Lazarus before he died? Anybody ever heard about Lazarus before he got sick? Anybody ever heard of Lazarus before he had his mishaps? You doctors here, Dr. Simone, Dr. McCall, Dr. Aubrey, Dr. Hannah, all your doctors. Amen. You doctor, anybody ever heard something about Lazarus? Pastor D, Dr. D, Dr. D, you ever heard anything that Lazarus did before he got sick? Sometimes your greatest triumph and your greatest power and your greatest testimony comes to the place of what looks like the crucible of your greatest affliction and your greatest test, and where people may say your life is nothing but stinking. Because Lazarus still has a name that means God had to help me. Let me finish reading and be done. And he says, I'm glad for your sake that I was not there, to the intent you may believe. Nevertheless, let us go unto him. Jesus said, I'm glad for your sakes that I was not there, to the intent that you may believe. Believe what? What are we supposed to believe, Jesus? You didn't go visit him when he was sick. What are we supposed to believe now? I'm glad I wasn't there. That's why the Lord does things like he did this morning. 11 Action News, Fox News, cops everywhere, crime tape, investigation officers all across the street, in my parking lot, news people here, amen, interviewing folks, wanted to highlight the fact that this happened. Didn't have nothing to do with the church. Didn't have anything to do with Spirit of Glory. Wanted to highlight the fact that it happened by the church. Why? And the Lord says, watch this. You may think this is bad publicity. Watch what I'll do. I'll blow people in here. Are y'all hearing me? Because in the places of your extremities, it's when Father says, oh, I'm glad. For your sake. All right, that's about all y'all can handle right now. So I'm about to stop. Just read out. Then said Thomas, 16. Then said Thomas, which is called Didymus, unto his fellow disciples, let us go that we may die with him. Thomas is just interesting. This was him being sarcastic. Like, don't you know that he was trying to kill you? Okay, we go with you. Let us go so we can die with you. Then when Jesus came, he found that he had lain in a grave. He had been in a grave for 4 days. I will have to do part two of this on sometime this week, because I'm really just getting started. Because if I have time, I will talk about the grave. I will talk about what happens after the grave. I will talk about what the process is of when we go into that space of obscurity and darkness and isolation. What's happening? What was Lazarus experiencing? What was going on in Lazarus' life in the time that he was in this grave? What was happening? What was taking place? What was transpiring?
I don't have time though. Verse 20. What was that verse? What verse? Verse number 21. I'm gonna skip down to verse number 21. Yep, verse number 21. Verse 21 says, "Then said Martha unto Jesus, then said Martha unto Jesus, if thou hadst been here, my brother had not died. But I know even now, whosoever will to ask of God, God will give it thee." And Jesus said unto her, "Thy brother shall rise. Thy brother shall rise again." Martha said unto her, "I know he shall rise again in the what? In the resurrection, in the wind, the last day. I know he'll rise again. I don't have any problem believing. My problem is what you want to do right now is where I'm struggling with, because had you come 4 days earlier, I could have been all right with the healing service. But now you want to wait 4 days, and now instead of having a healing service, now you want to have a resurrection service. Have you ever known the problem to get greater before God moved in your life? You may not be able to say amen, but I'm going to say amen right here. Had you come a few days ago, I could have believed this right here, but now it seemed like it's worse than what it was. Jesus said unto her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth on me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this?" Did you just catch what I just read? That's why he says, "I'm taking the sting away from death. If you believe on me," that's why Jesus uses terms different from what we are. But because they couldn't catch the revelation, he went on and said, "Okay, he did. I'm glad for your sake." But Jesus says, if you believe on me, he shall never die. Believe this. Verse 32 says, I'm skipping down for time's sake because we have to go. Verse 32 says, then when Mary was come where Jesus was and saw him, she fell down at his feet, saying unto him, "Lord, if thou hadst been here, my brother had not died." And when Jesus therefore saw her weeping, and the Jews also weeping, which came with her, and he groaned in the spirit and was troubled. He groaned in the spirit and was troubled. I want someone to say this with me. The Jews was there too. The same ones that just tried to kill him had to show up. It's all a setup. So he's groaning here. Verse 34, I'm almost finished. Hang out. I promise I am. And verse 34 says, "And said, where have you laid him?" They said unto him, "Lord, come on and see." Verse 35, Jesus did what? Jesus wept. I have asked the question many times, what were you weeping for? Were you weeping because of their pain? I've seen many instances where people were in plenty of pain that you never wept. Were you weeping because it was your friend Lazarus? You already knew you were going to raise him from the dead. So why are you weeping? He was weeping because they were trying to push back something that he showed up to do right now into sometime in the future, because he's trying to find somebody that can catch a hold to what he wants to do right now. And they're still trying to push back what he wants to do right now. And they're still preparing to say goodbye to Lazarus. But Jesus came to resurrect Lazarus. All right. Yeah. So Jesus wept. In verse 38, I'm going to skip to verse 38 and get out of here. But verse 38 says, "Jesus therefore, again groaning in himself, cometh to the grave. And it was a cave, and a stone lay upon it." Jesus said, he says, "Take away the what?" Take away the stone. Here we go. Martha, the sister of him that was dead, said unto him, "Lord, by this time he's what? He stank. By this time he stinketh, for it has been, he been dead 4 days." Why are you telling me to remove a stone from a man that has been here for 4 days. He's still trying to listen, to hear faith. Martha's statement once again was, this is stinking. Verse 40 says, Jesus said unto her, said I not unto you that if thou would believe, you should see the glory of God? So Jesus was not groaning because of grief for Lazarus. He was groaning because they couldn't believe for the next dimension that he was about to release upon their lives. God, I got to go. These people are tired and rocking back and forth looking sleepy. Thank you, Lord God, but I got this in my belly. They had seen healing. We saw blind eyes open. We've seen deaf ears unstopped. But we have never seen this before. May I just introduce this to somebody right now, that there's some things that God's getting ready to do in your life, that he's trying to get you into a place of believing to see something you have never seen before. This has never happened before. So he's groaning. I'm showing up as the resurrection, but you don't believe. Still trying to push it back. 41 says, he said, take away the stone. And they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid. And Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I thank you that you heard me. Verse 42 says, and I know that you hear me always. But because of the people which stand by, I said it, that they may believe. He's trying to get them to what? Believe. They may believe that you have sent me. And then verse 43 says, and when he thus had spoken, he cried with a loud voice. For those that have issue with me getting loud, he cried with a loud voice. And he said, Lazarus, 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 you got to come forth. It doesn't matter that you've been in there for 4 days. I showed up in this atmosphere because I'm not coming as a healer. I'm coming as the I am, the resurrection. But they only wanted to see me as a healer. What happens in your life when God wants to show you another dimension of himself, but you're stuck on what he had done in the past? I'm showing up as the resurrection. So I'm groaning because they only wanted me to be a healer. But I'm coming with something else. But they only want me to, they can only have faith and believe if I'm coming when Lazarus was sick. But I waited until he was in the tomb. But I'm showing up with something else because I got this whole town here that has just tried to stone me. This whole city is here that's looked at Mary anoint me with this ointment and they said it was a great waste, including my disciples. This whole town is here. I'm not coming as a healer because they've seen that. I'm not coming as the opening of a blinded eyes. They already saw that. I'm not coming to unstop deaf ears. I'm coming as I am, the resurrection. But they don't believe that. I want to charge this atmosphere right now in faith as I get ready to take my seat. In the name of Jesus, the I am is here. And there's some things that God's going to do in your life and you've not seen it before. But don't you dare allow the devil to push back what God wants to do in the now into sometime in the future because you can't believe. I prophesy faith over you. I speak now hope in you. I prophesy that your
your confidence will not fail, and you will not cast your confidence, which has great recompense and reward. For you got need of patience. If you've done the will of God, you shall receive the prize, and it shall keep on giving. It shall keep on flowing. It shall keep on flourishing in the name of Jesus. This is a time of notable miracles, a time that you're going to see exploits, a time that the devil's going to be shamed, and you're not going to be shamed. For your shame, you shall have double. You're not going down the same road again. You will not be tripped up again. I speak and declare in the name of Jesus, as we prepare to leave this room today, I prophesy now by the power and the authority of Jesus Christ, and you're rising up as a new vessel. You're rising up as a new man, and you're rising up as a new woman, because you're not coming back the same way you went down. I wish I had about 5 people in this room that would take about 15 seconds and give God the glory, because you got a word that's out on you, and there's a name that you got to walk out. And God says your name is God carrying purpose, and you must fulfill the will of God for your life. And the devil can't kill you. The devil can't destroy you. He can't take your life. But you got the power now to walk out the will of God in the name of Jesus. God, I thank you that you're doing something that eyes have not seen before. You're doing something that ears have not heard before. And you're doing something now that's not entered into our hearts, but you prepared them and you revealed them unto us by your Spirit. So God, we take time now just to shabak your name. I bless you for revival. I bless you for miracles. I thank you for breakthrough. I thank you for harvest now in the name of Jesus. God, we worship you, and God, we bless you now. I wish somebody in this room would just open your heart up and give God the glory one more time. Hallelujah. 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 I am the resurrection. I am the resurrection. I'm not coming as your healer. I'm not coming as the opening of the blinded eyes. I'm coming to do something that you've not seen before. It's the power. It's the power of the resurrection. Thank you, Jesus. I charge this atmosphere in the name of Yahshua HaMashiach. Jesus Christ, a charge this atmosphere that when you leave this place, you leave in this place with a new boldness. You leave in this place with a new place of power, a new place of prayer. God may have some people to call you. You may be assigned to pray for them, but just lift your hands up and say, God, I thank you for using me. Open doors in the name of Jesus. Open doors. Open up. Open up. Open, open up, open. In the name of Jesus, as we get ready to leave the sanctuary, if there's anyone here under the sound of my voice, if you're here right now, and you want to receive the gift of salvation, I'm going to give 3 appeals at one time. All you have to do with these appeals is raise your hands if that's you. You're here under the sound of my voice, and you want to receive the gift of salvation, number one. Or you want to rededicate your life back to God. You've allowed the cares of this world. You've allowed troubles and circumstances and issues and lust for other things to pull you away. And you want to rededicate your life back to God. We have time for you. You can receive the gift of salvation or rededicate your life back to God. Those are the first 2 appeals I'll give to you. If you answer yes to one of those appeals, lift your hands up in this room. Amen. If you answer yes to one of those appeals, one, just one of them, just raise your hand in this room. We'll see you and meet you where you are. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. My last appeal. If you're here and you've been sitting in this atmosphere and you recognize the value and the importance of being properly aligned and properly connected in the household of faith that's going to teach, minister, and preach the truth and the word of God, where Holy Spirit is flowing, the power of God is moving, it's important that you be aligned with the right house, the one that God's ordained. If that's you and you say, I want to be a part of Spirit of Glory Worship Center, we have time to receive you in in this house. If that is you, all you got to do is raise your hands and we'll see you. If you want to be a part of this body of believers at Spirit of Glory Worship Center, if that is you, lift up your hands. If that is you, raise your hands. Thank you, Lord. I see two hands. I see two hands. I see two hands. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Well, the next thing I'm going to ask you to do is for you to, if you can, amen, come down this aisle and just come to the front. And we're going to give God the praise with you and celebrate with you right now. Thank you, Jesus. If you raise your hand and become a part of Spirit of Glory Worship Center, we want the church to give God some glory in this house because he's sending them in. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Brother Xavier. Amen. Brother, thank you, God, for Sheila Russell and also Tiffany. Thank you. Thank you. We give God the praise and the glory. Come on, Spirit of Glory. You can do better than that. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What an awesome God. It's my amen corner right here. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Tanika's up here, you minister. For prayer. We need some ministers to minister with Tanika. She's here for prayer. And then we're going to receive these three souls into the body of believers at Spirit of Glory Worship Center. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you, Sheila. Sheila, what was your last name? Russell. Sheila Russell. Tiffany Holland. Holden. Prosper, right? Isaiah Prosper, Xavier Prosper Stevenson, that's Prosper. I love it. Can we give God the praise for these souls? Oh, bless your name. Listen, I want to receive you into our family. We're not trying to rush at all. We do have another service that has asked to rent our space for a service that starts in 30 minutes, but we want to receive you into our family. We want to receive your beautiful family into our home, into our family at Spirit of Glory Worship Center. So what I do right now is I'm going to make a vow and a covenant before God and everybody that's watching. The way I minister the word, sometimes I'll teach, sometimes I'll preach, sometimes I may exhort. Sometimes I'm going to just sit down and just share. But it's going to be the word of God for the edification so that we can grow. And I make a covenant before God, according to Jeremiah chapter 3, that will feed the word with knowledge and understanding. And I make that vow now before God needs witnesses that will walk in integrity. I'll strive to live holy and be a man of God, as well as my wife. So the Bible says overseers, a husband of one wife. So I vow, I make that covenant right now in the name of Jesus. You're welcome to go get, if you want to go get her, please by all means. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord. So I'm going to extend to you all now the right hand of fellowship. Sheila, Russell, Tiffany, Holden, Xavier, Prosper, we receive you into our family at Spirit of Glory Worship Center with open arms and gladness of heart. And the church, give God some praise and some glory in this house. Amen, amen, and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Now, if you don't mind, this lady right here, beautiful lady in the gold sweater, Apostle Linda Wilde, if you all would just go with her, and she's going to help get some information from you so that we can reach out to you and continue to minister to you this week. Amen. Is there anything else?
All right, everyone. So we're gonna be dismissed. So here's what I'm gonna ask you to do. I'm not trying to rush you all out, okay? But I do have to rush you all out of here, okay? And it's because, for no other reason, that a service is going on at 3 o'clock. They've actually rented the entire building. So the gathering in the back for fellowship, please keep that for 30 minutes. We appreciate everyone for honoring those that have birthdays in the month of March. But for time's sake, please keep that the 30 minutes. So I bless you all. You're welcome to come back. We look forward to seeing you back next week at the same time. Didn't God move today? Amen. He moved today powerfully. So bless God for you. Now unto him that's able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power both now and forever. God bless you all. You're released from the sanctuary, please, expeditiously. Blessings to you. Journey into the fellowship hall, and please expedite that 30 minutes, if you will, as they're coming in to set up for the 3 o'clock service. I love you all so much. Look forward to seeing you next week.